I wanted to. Oh, let me see. Does Starbucks have boba? Did they not have boba? I thought they had boba. I thought that was like a thing. Was that a lie? Is allegedly testing boba and people are losing it. Wait, was it for April Fools? No boba. People just make a secret menu that is like black tea and milk. Oh, okay. But it made me think of something that I wanted to talk about, which was basically when I heard that Starbucks had boba, they don't. But when I heard that, my assumption was that it would be vegan, you know, because Starbucks has been seeming to make things vegan recently, like a lot of their new drinks, or like have the option to be made vegan, you know, unless it's something weird that just can't be made vegan. But anyways, that's nice because it's sometimes hard to find vegan boba from boba places. A lot of the time they like sweeten the boba with honey, and then a lot of the time there's dairy in the drink, even if you can ask for it to be made with like soy milk or almond milk or whatever. Flavoring packets for some of the flavors have milk in them, or sometimes they say they have a dairy-free creamer or dairy-free cream, but the dairy-free creamer still has like, you know, some sort of dairy ingredient in it still, like whey or whatever. Yeah, it's like even when I've tried to like ask employees about it, it's still like confusing to know exactly if there's no milk or no whatever in your drink, you know? So I was like, that would be nice if like Starbucks had boba and you could actually like make sure that it was vegan, especially like online or whatever. But then I was like, that seems dumb. Like basically, for example, boba places that I'm go to now are like small businesses, like sometimes like family businesses. And I'm not 100% sure that what I'm ordering is vegan all the time. Like there might be like some sort of dairy ingredient in the powder, or like one of the boba places we were going to, it used to say that they sweetened their boba with brown sugar, but then now it doesn't say that anymore. So I'm kind of like, does that mean they stopped using brown sugar and now they're using honey, or like what is going on there? But like, I'd rather have a drink that is like maybe not fully vegan from like a small business like that, rather than getting something that's for sure fully vegan, but it's from like Starbucks. That's like a very specific example, but basically like that you could apply that to anything else, like getting Mexican food from like a family-owned small business then versus like getting Chipotle or whatever. Like there's tons of Mexican food here and it can be really hard to like find out if it's like fully vegan because there's so many like opportunities for it not to be. Like you could have chicken stock in the rice, you could have butter on anything, you could have cheese in anything, you could have lard in anything, whatever. Like there's just so many like ways that it could be not vegan and it's hard to be like sure. But like Chipotle, I know exactly what I'm getting. I know that what I'm getting is vegan for sure because I can look it up. But at the same time, like I think in the grand scheme of things, it's probably better for society as a whole, you know, to like order something that's like 97% vegan from like a small family-owned business and supporting them rather than like a large corporation, you know? So it's kind of like intrigued by that conversation. Like, I'm not saying like let's all go buy non-vegan food just because it's from a small business, but like, you know, I just feel like that's something interesting to point out. You know, I don't care just about being vegan. I care about being better for society as a whole. A small business, a like family-owned business is probably going to be less like wasteful and irresponsible when it comes to like the environment or whatever, or like their workers. Obviously, like you can be a small business and be like horrible, but you know, at the end of the day, it might uphold more vegan values to support small businesses than a large corporation. Yeah, that's just how I feel. Like I understand. I wouldn't like say people need to start doing that because like if it makes you uncomfortable to get something that may not be 100% vegan, that's totally understandable. Like if it makes you feel guilty, whatever. But I just like I'd rather promote that like it's not just about being vegan. I don't know, any like you could buy something from the store that is fully vegan, but it's like got unethical like palm oil in it. It has chocolate that's been like it's made with slave labor or whatever. The packaging is super wasteful or whatever. I don't know.
And then you have like the same candy or whatever from a company that isn't vegan, but like the packaging is recyclable and it was made fair trade, made with solar power. I don't know, like I wouldn't buy it if it had like milk in it, you know? I probably would just be like, oh, I'll just buy neither, I guess. But I'm just saying like at that point, I wouldn't like judge a person for choosing the thing that had like honey in it or whatever over the fully vegan one that was like unethical in every other way. You know, that was a bad way to explain that, but I think you guys probably get what I'm saying. I also work at a local cafe and we source most of our ingredients locally and try to support other local businesses whenever we can. And there's a lot less waste on the back end than I think there is probably at larger companies. Yeah, I would definitely imagine. And I always see like those videos of people having to like throw away, you know, all this food at the end of the day. I feel like corporations are always like the worst about that. Just forcing things to go to waste just because, you know, it's like reducing demand to just like give it out or whatever. Because like smaller companies need to be more efficient. They need to be less wasteful to save money themselves. You know, it actually matters for them. But like a corporation that has so much money coming in, they're more likely to just be like, ah, whatever, throw it away, whatever. At some point, if you are so inflexible about your values, it can actually become sort of harmful. Yeah. When I worked at a small bakery, we would always throw away racks and racks of donuts and other stuff. We could take as much as we wanted, but none of it was vegan, so I just bring one thing to my parents. I feel like, yeah, what I've heard from like smaller companies is that they still do that. Like they still like have to throw away a lot and have to be very wasteful because I feel like there's not a lot of ways around it. But like at least what I've heard about like smaller companies is that like they will allow like employees to take stuff home or allow like employees to eat stuff. But like a lot of corporations like just don't even let anyone take things, or you can get in trouble, you know, if you take food home. And that's like so fucking annoying. Those videos of people throwing out stuff makes me so sad. When I worked at a printing press, we had to cut and throw out so many misprinted shirts. Like the fact that you have to cut it up. I've seen those videos too where people are just cutting up products that they're not selling anymore or whatever. I mean, if you send them to like a Goodwill or whatever, something like that, they might still end up getting thrown away eventually. But maybe not. I don't know. Or like, you know how they like grind up fabric and like make it into like something else? That could be cool.